started creeping in 1958 with on Madampe with under a chap called Coburn, famous planter in his day. Then after creeping, I went to Deep Dean Estate Rakwana, same company, East India Company, managed by Boyce Brothers, under another well-known Sri Lankan planter called Chasiri Pereira, who's now dead and gone. He ended up as chairman of JDB. Anyway, then after 1.5 years, I came back to Madampe, worked under Coburn, and then when he left, when he retired, I was senior state. Then he was succeeded by Jack Van Prest. I worked on Nipana there 2 years, and from there I got my promotion to Mahausa Estate, Madrukale. I was there for 3 years.
Which year was that, Bhati?
1964 or 65. In between, before that, while seeing ST on Madampe, I acted on Deep Dean. So the Englishman went on leave, I acted for 4 months. Came back, and then I went to Deep Dean as superintendent. 65, I said, no, 65 to 68. Then the company decided to amalgamate Madampe and Deep Dean, for whatever reason. And then they asked me to go to a place called Nuli, because there was no superintendent job. Once they amalgamated, they put a ST in charge. Nuli Estate, Verniagala, same agency. And I was there for 5 years. At that time, I was appointed to Stafford Estate in Halganwe, which actually was owned by the owners were the same, is Esufalis. That was a small estate. Whilst I was there, I was also looking after Nuli. I used to go there once in 10 days or 2 weeks, and there was an estate there. Then, I think after 1972, which was after the insurrection, 72, I was sent to Valimada Group. And during that time, 75, no, the estates were taken over?
Yes, 75, it was the end of 75 when the management changed from the agency houses to the JDB and the SLSPC.
So that happened. Then in 79, that is under JDB, they sent me to Petersdale Estate, Agada. I was there for 5 years. Then I was transferred to Hootville Estate, Agrapatna. I was there for 7 years. Then they sent me back to Petersdale. For the chap who was there, he got a job in South Africa and he went home.
That was Kumar Gunasekera.
Yeah. And I was there for 5 years. So then, at the stages, I was actually not running the estate. I was resident there, but I was looking after a group of estates. By the time Pusala plantations had taken over, and so I was doing their work. Starting with the bosses, there was Jasiri Pereira, who actually I really got my grounding with him, because he is one of these olden day planters who, particularly he got a new chap to work under you. For example, for 1.5 years I worked under him. I had a motorcycle, he didn't allow me to use it. So you just hoofed it throughout. And I came to Madampe, and I think that's where I really learned to plant him, because Coburn, I mentioned his name earlier, a very difficult character. In fact, when I was ST there, he fired 2 STs, because he was a very difficult man to get on with. But I really learned my work under him, because he was apart from being a good agriculturist, a very good administrator.
He was also a very idiosyncratic character, no, from what you hear.
Yeah, lots of stories about him. Yeah, chronic man he was, very difficult chap. Then Van Prest also was, in his own way, he was difficult chap. But I could, but so those were the three people I worked on. Yeah, there was a Raston Tissera, who's no longer there. I got to know him when I came to Stafford, and I learnt a lot of manufacture from him, which I didn't know. Upcountry manufacturer, he then him, and then there was his cousin, Ralston and Aubrey and Clive.
And Clive. Yeah.
And of course Vernon, Ralston's brother. But Low Country, I knew a number of chaps, both three of those had died. Nandel Lavan, name may be familiar, he was a politician. Because he and I started life together. He was in Finlay's. We joined on the same year, and then we got involved in politics. He left, I was very close to him. Another chap called Lucky Sail Singh, who is in Australia. So those were basically the, and of course chaps like Manilal Nabewadana and William Balthasar, who's Pandas, both of them are dead.